Who are you now?
I am Alan Carter of Carter Comics.
Now, how did Carter Comics come into being?
Oh, that actually started when I was 8 years old. I was always into, like, superhero cartoons and
right.
translated to comics. And I was like, you know what? I don't want to do, like, you know, have my characters with Marvel. I want to do my own characters.
Right.
Let's do, like, Carter Comics. Like, great alliteration. And even at 8, I thought about that. And I was like, you know, it just, like, work. Use my last name. So I wanted to build my own brand of, you know, characters. Like, superhero teams. Like, you know, goofy tourists and, you know, animal characters. So I wanted to, you know, build my own empire even from that age, even at 8 years old.
So you mentioned that you were in Hawaii. Was this before you came stateside or what?
Oh, yes, because I was born and raised in Hawaii, and I moved here at age 25.
Here's the artist right here.
Yeah, take a look.
This is my first time at one of these things. I'm doing something outside of my box.
Well, I'm glad. Like, you picked a great book to start.
Yeah, I've never been in a really the comics or anything, and I work in a theater, so we have a lot of the movies. I was like, dang, I didn't know, like, it's big business of the movies, too.
Oh, yeah.
This is so wonderful. Hopefully you'll even be able to get into that.
Yeah, definitely. And that's like, this is really for like the non-comic reader, because this is like a parody. It's like making fun of obnoxious tourists. All their bad habits are superpowers.
They always have.
Yeah, so if you've gone on vacation, you either encountered them, you either had friends who were like them, maybe you're one of them at some point. Oh, yeah, actually, my third issue, it takes place in L.A., so they land in Venice Beach and walk up to the pier.
I know, I always saw them on the bus, like, carrying luggage in all different languages, trying to figure out how to pay for their bus. So you write and, like, do you draw this stuff, too, or do you have, like, a...
There's just original artwork right there.
Really? Oh,
yeah, so, yeah, I'm a one-man show, so I do the writing, and then I do the art. So I'll start on this, I'll do like pencil ink, hand-drawn, I'll reduce it at Kinko's, I'll scan it into Illustrator to like smooth the lines out, take it into Photoshop, and then do the coloring, and then do the actual dialogue, and do adult dialogue.
Oh, yeah. Do you ever help, like say if someone has ideas, do you ever help something and see if you consider it. But you said you've been turning
It's been, I've been doing conventions about 8 years.
And then,
Yeah, about the same time. As soon as I went to my, I was going to be booked for my first show, and I said, oh, okay, I got to get these printed, and then I have to see, like, published for that. But then I self-published for that. So that way, you know, I'm a control freak, so I want to make sure everything's perfect. Everything's the way I want. Before you go, I will give you a master's postcard.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful.
Yeah, there's actually a shot of the pier on the other side.
Oh, yeah, cool.
Right. No problem. You too.
Well, since you like control, you know that Dianne Feinstein is leaving her office this year. Dianne Feinstein?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You interested?
Maybe.
State Senate seat? Go on a Carter ticket?
Yeah, I'll be waiting in the wings.
So if you're artwork, I know there's a lot more humor, because I see a lot of, like, really, steroids, testosterone comics, and your work is more friendly looking, I guess?
Yeah, I do like a mix, because this is more science fiction.
Yeah.
There's superhero elements in it, but
yeah.
The base is the science fiction, because it's, people having to deal with, like, missing time and...
Well, I can see on Fuse, yeah. Like science fiction.
Yeah, and, like, just the mystery of, like, what happened to them, and then their abilities are mysterious, and, you know, in sci-fi, like, there's a lot of tech involved with the military that are trying to fight off these characters who think that, you know, they're a threat.
Is it, like, alien abduction or something, or what?
It's very much like an Unsolved Mysteries, Spy in Disguise type of deal.
Yeah.
Very much into that, so I wanted to write a story like that.
When you said missing time, I thought of alien abductions, and they say, I don't know where I was, but they give them hypno-regression, and they find out they were taken on the spaceship.
Yeah, there's like a two-year gap for the character,
yeah.
So they can't account for what happened in the 2 years.
Again. Yeah.
That might be how they got their abilities, but they don't know who did this to them or what did this to them. And, you know, they learn, they actually find out, and, well, the reader finds out at the end of issue 6, which I just finished inking yesterday.
Yeah.
So that should probably be done in time for my next show in May, Comic-Con Revolution in East LA Cape. So probably in mid-April, like, they'll be done.
Now, what is East LA Cape?
That's at Ogallala Plaza, just in East Los Angeles. It's Saturday, May 12th, from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m., and it's free admission.
Now, it's called CAPE, because it's comic books, or what?
It's acronym for Comic Arts Pop Culture Expo.
Oh, East LA CAPE. So you're going to come as a Carter, or you're going to come in cosplay?
I'll be there as Carter Comics. I'll be there as a vendor. I went there last year as an attendee, because I wasn't able to get in time, and the turnout was huge.
Yeah.
There was a line around the block at 2 o'clock, and they've been open since 11. And I was so happy for them. Now, it was pretty hot outside, so
right.
I was hoping I could get in at some point. And it wasn't air-conditioned, but just seeing those crowds, like, I want to be behind that table and, you know, experience all of that.
Because I remember one time we at the Punky Nerd, you came dressed as Nick Fury.
Oh, that was a favor for my friends at Fanbase Press.
Yeah.
Who was debuting their new character. It was Stanley M. Jackson.
Yeah, I remember Jehudi was there, too.
Yeah.
Jehudi. And I thought I saw that Christy Shin was going to be here, too.
She is. I can't remember her Artist Alley table number offhand.
Yeah.
Yeah, but she's there. I think she might be in either the C's or the D section.
Yeah, I thought
she's there. Yeah, I came by this morning before the show and I talked to her.
Anything else you want to say about Carter Comics? Anything else you want to say about Carter Comics?
Oh, yeah. I'll say this about Carter Comics up at WonderCon. If you have a Sunday ticket, you have a 3-day badge, and you're not here, get down here. Get down to Small Press Table 114.
Yeah.
Check out your damn tourists. Check out Love Weeks Mondays, your Cosmic Force, and see some new comics. You can laugh with damn tourists. You can find out the mystery of the Cosmic Force, and you can test your figure speech, pop song, TV show, movie, or band name knowledge with Love Weeks Mondays.
I remember that. Yeah, I got one of those. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, being that you're very animated when you speak this, are you very animated when you're writing your stories? You're up in front of a mirror or something, or what?
Oh, always, because it energizes you when you write your story, because if you're after the story and, you know, maybe you're kind of burned out, you know, it you know, gives you the energy to keep going with the story. And it's, right. especially if you're stuck on a scene, it's like, how am I going to access the scene? It's like, okay, what's this guy doing? It's like, oh, he's mad. He's like, he's saying, like, you know, oh, you know, where are these aliens? Or, like, yeah. or, you know, oh, these, like, tourists are annoying, you know, or, you know, laugh or get angry, you know, just try to, you know, think what the characters are thinking. Like, I always think of that, like,
yeah.
what does this character feel? Like, how would I feel in this situation? That's what helps to write out a scene, and that's what helps to develop a character as well.
Yeah. So when Alan Carter is being created, he's a very animated character himself, I guess.
Oh, yeah. It might be the only time, but it's the time when it has where I'm animated.
But I need cooler heads up in Sacramento. All right.